our first contender for the Balls of Steel crown? The big gay following. Take a seat. That felt good. Vaseline?
Oh, good for me too, yeah.
Definitely. Big gay following, it's great to have you on the show.
Nice to be back.
What's been keeping you from the sing-along of Sound of Music this week?
Oh, not too much. I've been hanging about at celebrity bashes, chatting up famous names.
Oh, and who have you met?
I met one of my heroes, actually, Tony Blackburn.
Did he make your day?
No, but I hoped I could make his whole week.
I think I half understood that, and I think it's disgusting. Let's take a look.
Tony, I'm Entertainer, Channel 4. You got a moment for me, sir?
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Good.
Absolutely.
How are you?
Fine, very well, thanks.
Very
well.
Are you presenting tonight, sir?
I'm giving away a prize for competitions.
Good. Do you fancy a bum?
How do you mean, sorry?
Oh, do you fancy a bum? Little man-on-man action.
Not really, no.
You sure?
No.
Got time before the show starts?
Quickie. I don't think so. Very kind of you.
Hi, Jeremy, I'm Entertainer, Channel 4, a new innovative programme. You got a moment?
Yes, absolutely, yeah.
You fancy a bum?
Do I fancy a bum?
Yeah, fancy a bum.
Do you know what? Not before dinner.
You sure? Yeah. How about after dinner then? After. What are you doing tonight then?
Started working for a new radio station. We're out for a few awards.
Yeah. Good. Do you fancy a bum?
Do what?
Fancy a bum.
What do you mean, fancy a bum?
You fancy a bum? You know, a bit of me. Me action. Me and you.
No, not my cup of tea. I've kind of happily married, I'm afraid.
Cup of coffee, yes, all right. Married men are the best ones, I think.
Cup of coffee is fine, you see, but that's probably where I draw the line.
Channel 4, Entertainer. Do you have a moment for us, sir?
Yeah.
Good. How's your lovely wife with you today?
What were you expecting?
I don't know, actually.
Bring
somebody else's lovely wife.
Bring the other wife.
Well, yes, I don't know. So, do you fancy a bum?
Fancy a bum.
Do you fancy a bum?
A bum?
Yeah.
What's a bum?
You like a bum, little man-on-man action, me and you.
No, I don't think so.
I wasn't asking you, Mrs. Hamilton, I was asking the Grand Miss Neal.
No, well, these sort of things you want to do.
Are you in a kind of 69, Mr. Hamilton?
I don't think that's the sort of thing one does for Channel 4.
For sure.
Well, we're here because Kate's presenting an award tonight, and we'll probably see some old friends from a long time ago, so it'd be nice to be a part of it.
Sounds good. Do you fancy a bum?
Oh, beg your pardon?
Do you fancy a bum?
What, from you?
Yeah, a bit of man-on-man action.
Do you know what?
A bum?
No, yeah, he's one of these smart asses, don't worry.
Gosh, what a rousing start. Good morning and welcome to the last Right Stuff of the Week with me, Matthew.
I have a whistleblower.
I mean, it takes guts to confess, but we've got one here. Eric, tell us your story.
Hi, Matthew.
Hiya.
Do you fancy a bum?
Fancy a bum. In what sense?
You know, like a bit of man-on-man action. Do you fancy a bum?
Okay, thanks very much. What a strange man.
You're late, you know, mate.
I know, perfectly timed. Okay. I don't want to hang out in a room full of disc jockeys.
Do you know, do you fancy a bum?
Do I fancy a bum?
Yeah.
What, as in a gay bum?
Yeah, as in a gay bum. Fancy a bum.
With you?
Why not, yeah. So you don't want to hang out in there, we could hang out somewhere else together.
All right.
Yeah.
Now? Yeah.
We love Chris Moyles. What a hero. You really lucked out there, didn't you?
No, he's gay, my old roly-poly.
I did think it was unnecessary to actually shag him, by the way.
Oh.
And tell me, were you actually on live daytime TV, The Right Stuff, presented by Matthew Wright?
I was, yeah, 9 o'clock in the morning.
Matthew Wright had to ask you at least 2 times what you were asking for, didn't he?
He likes to play coy, Matthew, doesn't he?
Outrageous stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, the big gay following.
Well done, big guy.